Welcome to the 30th World Trampoline and Tumbling Championships in Daytona Beach, Florida. Today we'll see the finals in the men's synchronized event and the women's individual trampoline event. These are the top eight qualifiers in the men's synchronized event. This is the first event of the evening. As you can see, China is on top, then the leaders, they compete last because they had the highest score in the qualifying round. The first team we're seeing is a team from Poland, Tomasz Andecki and Artur Zakrzewski. They have to signal each other to go, and then they count to two. And that's how they know when to start. Here they go. Very good synchronization. Nice kickouts right at the same time. The judges like that. Wow. And they end with a full twisting, double back straight. It was a clean routine. It was such good synchronization, and they're a great match. They kick out at the same time. Looks really good, and they didn't miss a beat. They do two trifluses, which is a triple somersault with a half twist, and then there are a lot of double somersaults with multiple twists. They keep their body straight and clean and tight. Those are good for the execution scores, but their synchro score is what's going to keep them in the top. It's a beautiful routine by the team from Poland. And they have a score of 49.4, which puts them in the lead. And they're happy. And this is a team from Belarus, Nikolai Kazak and Vladislav Gancharu. Vladislav is the current European champion. They need to beat 49.4. Little travel, but good synchronization. Very clean. Wow, it's going to be difficult to decide which team was better. That was an excellent routine. The synchronization was good. There's a little travel in this close trampoline, but their difficulty was higher and possibly had higher execution scores. It's hard to tell from here. That's a triple front with a half twist piked. And another triple. And there they go with their multiple twisting doubles. But they do a few more twists than the Polish team, which adds difficulty. They're slightly off there, but it's so minor. That was an excellent routine by the team from Belarus. Beautiful kickouts. That means they finished their skill at top. It's very definitive. There they go. They're in the lead with a score of 49.6. They're 2/10 ahead of the team from Poland. Now we have two brothers from Australia. This is Ty and Sean Swaddling. They are the Australian champions. They're counting their start. There they go. Nice start. Oh, a little travel. Back in the middle. Oh, now they're getting off. So obviously this affects their synchronized score. It will be quite a bit lower than the Poles in the Bulgarian. Oh! And that's a huge deduction. Sean hit the blue. That means that once you touch any part of the equipment that isn't the trampoline bed, your routine is terminated. So he's only getting scored out of 9, which is a huge deduction. And then if you include the synchronization deductions, it would be very, very difficult for this really talented team to be on the podium. They just had a bad day. But they got back together there, and then disaster struck. It's too bad for the guys from Australia. But they're brothers, so it's okay. And they've won a lot of meets together before. They're in fourth so far. Now, the Japanese always have excellent synchronized teams. They are often on the podium. They're excellent at this. It's something that they're very strong at and that they excel in. And this is Masaki Ito and Yoshihiro Uyama. One of them will signal to go. They'll count to two and then go. Here they go. That's a triple, another triple, and another triple. That's a lot of difficulty in there. Synchronization is excellent. They're slightly off right there, and a little travel. When you travel, it's hard to keep your synchronization, but they got it back, and they're together at the end. Great, and they end that routine with a triple twisting double back in the straight body position. We call that a Miller, because it was named after the first trampolinist to ever do it, Wayne Miller. Even though their synchronization was off, they had such high difficulty that there's hope for them to be on the podium. And three triples. Lots of twists in those doubles. But they're a little off, and there's their Miller. And their form was good, so they do have a chance. Well, that puts them in third, and he's squinting his nose because there's still a couple of others ahead. It's going to be tough to get on the podium. And with Dong Dong and Tu Chao ahead, you can almost guarantee that they're going to do very well. These guys have won everything, and they are world champions. And individually, they're world champions. And Dong Dong's an Olympic champion. They throw extremely high difficulty. Watch their first skill. It's a 1.5 twisting triple front, and they actually do two of those. They do one in the pike position and one in the tuck position. So here it goes. And they make it look easy. Just watch. There we go. Rudy out trip. A little off, but they'll get back together. They always do. And that's their breather skill, back pike. Another triple, and their excellent synchronization. And if you notice their kickouts, they do it exactly the same time. They look like a mirror image of each other, which is the objective. That was a great routine by Dong Dong and Tu Chao, the world champions. I think they have a great chance of defending their title. And Tu Chao feels confident, that's for sure. Rudy out Triffus, and then another Triffus. Those are triple somersaults, and another triple somersault, and lots of twists. But look how they extend their bodies at exactly the same time. It's easy to like that. That's beautiful. And they end their routine with a triple twisting double back straight. Here we go. Nice. There's the winners, and they won by more than 2 points. Dong Dong and Tu Chao from China, 51.7 world champions who defended their title again. So the Chinese win again. It's no surprise to a lot of people because they win a lot. But Poland and Belarus were excellent, and Poland should be very proud. This is their first medal in synchronized in the World Trampoline Championships. So here's our medal winners. In third place from Poland, that's Artur Zakrzewski and Tomasz Adamczyk. And our silver medalist, Władysław Gonciarow and Nikolaj Kazek. And gold medalists, once again, from China, Dong Dong and Tu Chao.
Dong Dong and Tu Chao.
These guys have won so many gold medals in their life, and I'm sure that each one is special.
The gold medal is presented by FIG Secretary
General. Can never get tired of winning.
The silver medal is presented by Trampoline Technical Committee member Xing Liu. And the bronze medal will be presented by FIG honorary member and FIG auditor Ron Froelich.
The young Vladislav right there is the European champion in individual trampoline. Next up will be the women's individual trampoline final. But in the semifinals, Dawn Li from China was eliminated. She is a world champion in 2010, but China is, each country is only allowed two competitors in the finals. And already two of them have done great routines. And when Dawn Li went up to jump to do her routine, she had a disastrous ending and she was eliminated. She had a great start. She started with a huge trick, a Triffus Pike, triple somersault and half twist, and she did it again in tuck position. But she's kind of stuck right there. And she could not continue to save herself. And then it just got difficult and she lost it right there. And unfortunately, that eliminated her chance to defend a gold medal. So now two of her teammates will go to finals, but not Li Dan. And that's where the problem started right there, and she could not fix it. It's a huge disappointment for her. She only scored 41.92, put her in 20th. Only eight go to finals, and only two for any country. These are the finalists. And the leader is a new member of the Chinese team, Liu Lingling, has never been on the international stage before, and look where she is. She's ahead of Rosanna McLennan, who is an Olympic champion, and she's ahead of two European champions, and she's ahead of Zhang Jingping, her teammate, who has already two medals in world championships. So our first competitor is Tatiana Piotrynia. She is a European champion in individual trampoline. She has proven herself time and time again to be consistent and strong and clean. And here she goes at triplets, piked. She does one triple in her routine, which is still excellent. And she's in the middle, which is great. She's starting to lose a little height here, which will be reflected in her score, but she's getting back up there. There you go. That was a nice routine by Tatiana. Nice start with that triple. And then that's a 1.5 twisting double front. She has a lot of multiple twisting doubles in her routine, which increases her difficulty. And then she's getting ready for the end of her routine. And it's a half inrudiat, which is a double twisting double back in the piked position. She lost a little height halfway through her routine, which is going to affect her time of flight. And it somewhat will affect her execution scores as well, because the higher you are, the better you can do. But she's in the lead. She's the first one up at 53.5 is a good score. It possibly can get a medal. She'll just have to wait and see. This is Kat Driscoll from Great Britain. She's been recovering from nagging injuries, but she's back on the trail, and she wants to go to Rio. She is an Olympian already. She starts her routine big, also with a triple in the pike position, and then she does another one in the tuck position. She's got a lot of difficulty, and she's very strong, and she's very clean. There, she's still in the middle. That's great. And she's maintaining her height as well. Nice. And she ends her routine with a double twisting, double back, straight, full in, full out. She should be really happy with that. I think that's podium worthy. And let's see what the judges think. Oh, she's happy. She's relieved. She's gotten strong. She's back in the back in action. Two trifuses. And that's a 1.5 twisting double front. She has a breather skill, a double back pike. Another double. And then she sets up for her dismount, which is a double twisting double back. Very confident, very solid. She maintained her height. She should have a good time of flight score. There's her second triple. And there she is. She's in the center, maintaining way up there. Great routine for Kat. There you go. She's in the lead with 53.56. And that's podium worthy. Now, Anna Garchanuk is from Belarus. She's also a European champion. Anna's strategy is a little different than some of her competitors. She doesn't have triples in her routine, but what she does is immaculate. And so her strength is her form and her height. So 1.5 twisting double front, full twisting double back. And see, she's way up there. And when she finishes her skills right at the top, extends her legs even early, like that, on double back pike. And she's right in the middle and ends her routine with a double twisting double back straight, just like Catherine's. But she had no triples, but it was super clean and super high, and she will be rewarded for that. Look how high up there she is. And she stays up there throughout the entire routine. She doesn't lose an inch of height. That takes a lot of power and a lot of strength. You can see it in her shoulders and her arms right there. She reaches up and keeps her skills right over the cross. And those nice extensions, when she extends her legs right there, that shows the judges that she's completed the skill confidently. She takes the lead with 53.975, just a couple of tenths ahead of Catherine Driscoll. Now, this is Zhang Qingping. She has two medals from former world championships. She's one of China's veteran performers. She has a lot of power, a lot of difficulty, a lot of height. Let's see what she does. See, her arms pull her up, pulls her height up. Here we go. Her triple. And then she does another one. Excellent. Little towards the side. It's affecting her performance when she gets too close to the springs, but she's back in the middle. Good routine, very good routine. A little travel where Anna didn't travel at all. So we'll see how that affects her score, because she does have higher difficulty and she has really high time of flight. There's her second triple. She gets close to the springs, as you can hear it actually, but she gets back into a straight plane of action closer to the springs. She still kind of is struggling with her travel, but she maintains her form and she maintains a significant amount of height. Trifus pike. That's a full twisting double back, and here's her second triple. And that's what we call a breather skill, a double back tuck, because it gives her a break. And let's see what happens. Wow. Fourth place for Zhang Qingping with a 52.8. She doesn't get a medal this time. Here's Rosie McLennan. Rosie has planned to make history here, and let's see if she does it. She plans to do 3 triple somersaults in a row. No woman has ever done that in competition. She's going for mega difficulty. That's one of her strengths, though. Rosie is a beast. She can do the big tricks. But nobody's seen her do this full routine. So let's see what she does. Let's see how high she gets. She has to be that high in order to throw 3 triples in a row. She's up. Okay, here she goes. Triffus Pike. Happened, Triffus? Triffus Tuck, she did. She did the 3 triples in a row. Now she has to finish her routine. She's a lot of twists in there. And here's a dismount. Full in, full out, straight. That was a great routine for Rosie. She made history. Rosie McLennan, Olympic champion from Canada. Rosie's teammate, Karen Coburn, had to go home. And Karen was been in 4 Olympics, and she's got 3 Olympic medals. And so it's tough for the Canadian team. They miss her, and they wish that she was here to see Rosie make history. And here is her last couple of skills, where she sets up for her dismount, full in, full out, straight. She's in the lead with a 55.13, time of flight 16, difficulty 16.6. That's some big stuff. Now this is interesting. This is Lu Lingling. She is new to the Chinese team. She's young, and she's in the lead. She beat world champion Dan Li, and she beat Zhang Qingping to get there. It's amazing. She is a beautiful, beautiful gymnast. She's very, very high, very clean. She was very impressive in semis and in qualifiers. There's her triple. She's way up there. She doesn't do 2 triples, but what she does is extremely clean, and she hasn't left the cross. She's still in the box, still in the cross. Beautiful kickouts. Wow. Wow, Lu Lingling never competed at the World Championships before, and she competes like a veteran. There's her triple. Nice pike position. There's all of her positions are very, very clean, very tight. The judges love that. They look for that. They look for those extensions when you finish your skill, you're getting that straight body and holding the straight body as long as possible before you land. And she's definitely got that down to an art form. Nice position, look at that. Full twisting double back. This is a 1.5 twisting double front in pike position. And Lu Lingling beats the Olympic champion. She beats world champions with a 55.99 score. She is the 2014 world champion for women's trampoline, Lu Lingling. And she gives Rosie a hug, Kat a hug. Wow. Look at that. Rosie's been in second before. It's not new to her, but these last couple of years, she's been the gold medal winner. And she made history tonight with her 3 triples in a row, and Lu Lingling made history as well. Here's our medalist. This is Anna Gorchanek from Belarus, European champion. And our silver medalist, Rosie McLennan from Canada. The history-making trampolinist.
First place, winner of the gold medal and world champion.
And first place, Lu Lingling from China, the world champion for 2014. The young new member of the Chinese team. And that means that China wins 2 gold medals tonight in women's individual and men's synchronized. So that ends today's show. Today's finals in women's trampoline and men's synchronized. And tomorrow will be women's synchronized and men's individual trampolining. So thank you for watching the 2014 World Trampoline Championships from Daytona Beach, Florida.